What's mofongo?
Mofongo.
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 I heard it. The Kemba Mutombo. Okay, so then we're not going to record the sparring, of course. How many rounds do you do on this day of this stage again? We're like 2 weeks out.
I'm going to get 6 in today, probably.
6, just like work.
And then, yeah, I'm going to get on the, finish my work on the heavy bag and everything.
Oh, did you guys see Paulie Malignaggi slap that guy?
Yes, I did.
What did you think of that? That was a real slap.
I thought he treated the shit out of him. And then what he said to him after, he was like...
Paulie's a real motherfucker, that's
he's
right.
Like that, he's like, that was a bitch slap for a bitch. And then I was like,
wow, what would you do if someone slapped you like that?
Oh shit, man, it'd be on. I fucking steal off his ass. But, I mean, he caught him. He caught him. There was enough, like...
George, if someone slapped you like Paulie slapped Artem Lobov, what would you do?
I shoot motherfuckers. I don't fight back. I'm a dirty motherfucker.
Buddy, did you see Paulie Malignaggi slap that UFC guy?
Yeah.
What did you think?
You slap me, I'm going to shoot your motherfucking ass.
What did you think? What did you think of that?
I'd rather punch me in the face and slap me like a bitch, man. I'd rather punch me in the face, man.
Did you see that?
Real.
You didn't see the slap? That was a slap.
Yeah, that was. I was surprised. That don't seem like Paulie.
Yeah. Well, no, it was personal. Paulie has been going at it with Conor ever since they sparred before the Mayweather fight.
Okay. What is going on? Is he really fighting that guy?
He's going to fight. No, not get that guy. He's fighting someone else. And then if he wins, he's going to fight that guy.
Well, Paulie's fighting for real?
Yeah. Bare-knuckle boxing.
Bare-knuckle boxing.
So you don't have any gloves. Just a little wrap over your knuckles. Use the trainer, buddy.
Use the trainer. But he doesn't need it.
But he wants to fight.
I want to fight too, but shit.
He'll do okay. What happened in Chicago? There's an actor named Jesse Smollett. He got jumped in your city.
Yeah, he didn't get jumped. That's full of shit. I knew. When a motherfucker gets jumped in Chicago, he's in the hospital. That bitch was not in the hospital. That motherfucker, you listen, that's a love affair gone wrong. That motherfucker just...
Hey, he got off, though. Daylight.
Yeah, get off.
Let 16 felonies. Yeah, and then he doesn't
even... No, he got off, but let the Justice Department get his ass. I hope they lock that bitch up. Fuck that motherfucker.
Yeah, he owes the city $130,000 to police.
Oh, he got... They're going to get paid.
4 feet of 10 already. He's 4 feet of 10.
Yeah, but what's 10,000 compared to 130?
He what?
How do you do?
4 feet of the bail.
Oh, he got money. He got the... The city going to get paid. Yeah, you know. And I hope he never acts again, that goofy ass motherfucker.
We're going to talk the game plan tomorrow.
Have you been studying a lot of Danny Garcia videos?
That's one of the things that I do on the regular, and that's a must for me. I always do it.
What do you see? What does he do great? What do you think you can take advantage of? Without giving away your game plan.
Let me tell you, and put it this way. I've always liked Danny Garcia because, of course, I'm Puerto Rican. I always take pride in.
He's a good dude.
He's a Puerto Rican, and I'm Puerto Rican. So I take pride in that. And I take pride in the fact of what he's accomplished because he represents our people. And our people, you know, we're a people that people look, you know, we're not respected as first-class citizens in the United States. And
you were in the Army, in the military.
I was in the Army.
Many years.
About 6 years. I did 6 years in the Army. Okay. And even all that doesn't matter. You know,
when you come back, they don't...
It doesn't matter. The worst thing, Vietnam veterans got treated the worst out of all veterans.
Sad, sad.
So, you know, I don't want to get into that. But in boxing, story-wise, we Puerto Ricans are bright people. And I take pride in Danny Garcia for all his accomplishment. But this is business. Adrian Granado and him are going to fight. And I'm with Adrian Granados, and I'm going to stick to Adrian Granados to the bone.
Now, Adrian Granados had two very tough fights where they were very close, which was the Broner fight and the Sean Porter. Now, Sean Porter fight, no one gave him a chance. They thought it's going to be over in one, and in the end of the fight, it was controversial.
Oh, yeah, because that's the type of fighter Adrian is. People think that Adrian is a pushover. Adrian is just a...
Been in a bad fight, ever.
He's just a man that hasn't gotten the opportunity that some of these guys got. Some of these cats been spoon-fed. He hasn't been spoon-fed. He had to come from the...
Who do you think is spoon-fed in boxing?
Huh? Who do you think? Do we need to say? When you can cherry-pick and pick who your opponent's going to be, what you call that? Or when you got the...
I would say good management.
Yeah, oh yeah, but we didn't have that good management.
Yeah, we ain't got nothing against it. I mean,
no, no, that's part of the game.
It's,
you know,
there's a lot of fighters, they get that look, you know.
No, I know, I'm joking, of course. You're right. They go the easy route, the easy route. I mean, you didn't have it easy.
No, and I didn't. I always had to hold down the side job.
Buddy, over here.
Buddy, they told me something I couldn't believe. They said there's some fighters that cherry pick opponents. Could that be?
No question.
Hey, buddy. Who is that little junior welterweight softball?
But how's camp going so far? Everything good?
Camp going the weather? You know, it's going to court. It couldn't get no better. You know, I wish, you know, I wish that, I wish his whole family was here to watch this and be a part of this. But, you know, this is an Adrian Granato moment. It's another one for his career. Hopefully, you know, he'll take this and relish it for the rest of his life. And hopefully he's victorious and, you know, make another, you know, huge fight.
People watching this video, Adrian Granato's, what should they know about? Who is Adrian Granato?
No, a tough warrior that take it to anybody. I mean, everybody know I ain't afraid to back down from nobody. If you're going to be a fight with me, it's tooth and nail. And, I mean, you're not going to be in an easy fight with me. But I'm tired of being known as a journeyman or a gatekeeper. I think I believe I belong where I'm at.